Now, I'm here today with Tracey Cross, who is co-chair of FSC's D&I Committee and part of the leadership of Empower Women. I have a few questions for you, Tracey. We all want to hear about Empower Women and a little bit about your journey. So that's where I'd like to start. So tell me about your journey and tell me why you are so passionate about women's financial literacy.
Okay. Where do I start? It started back when we established Women's Super, which was, 20 odd years ago. And that was all around identifying the issues that sort of women face and sort of providing for their financial well-being and getting a lot more sort of awareness of those issues and then advocating sort of around that. So it's been sort of a long journey up until that point. I think that, over my time, my own financial confidence and well-being could have been better. I have a 17-year-old daughter, and I would certainly like to think that, we could move the dial for her and for others. I think that there are specific issues that face women in providing their financial well-being. We know what the issues are, the pay you need to get, the taking time out of the workforce to have and look after children. When living longer, a lot of our financial products aren't designed for women. The list goes on, and we saw that with the Retirement Commission's release of the Kim Saver contribution gap yesterday. We're talking about these things, but there's just not enough change. So I guess that's why I'm very passionate about the space.
That was an excellent piece of research coming out of the Retirement Commission. And you've been on this journey for quite some time. You mentioned you've got a 17-year-old daughter. Can you consider where you were when you started this journey, where we are now? Are you seeing changes? Are we in a better place?
I don't think we're in a good enough space. I think there are things that will change, something that's more awareness and there's more discussion. But as to actually impactful change, I think we're dragging change here a bit. I don't think we have enough focus on designing product that's appropriate for women. And we really need to all get around the table to actually talk about these things and to drive purposeful action.
When we talk about women, they're a consumer group in their own, and I would imagine they have, a huge potential in terms of the marketplace. Can you tell me a little bit about where you see that growth of women as a consumer of natural products?
Look, I think that's a really good point, Rochelle, because we had our breakfast at conference last year was around what women want in financial products and how industry and providers can actually connect with them, which we thought would be a great topic and of interest to a lot more than what we had in the room. The room was full, but we just didn't have diversity of presence. There's a lot of information coming out at the moment and reports around, and I saw a heading, the feminization of women and wealth. And it talks about the trillions of funds that is going to come into the hands of women over the next decade. Now, I don't know why that wouldn't be a topic of interest for providers to really know more about and to understand. And I think JB Weir put out a recent report, and it focused on sort of that experience in Australia. And some of the detail comes out of that. It's really interesting. The number of female millionaires is just growing exponentially compared to male millionaires. So there's a really good story happening there, and a lot of stuff that we can sort of do to get behind this. Women are becoming a very powerful segment, as you've identified. We do make a lot of the household buying decisions, so we need to be brought to the table.
Nice. You mentioned Australia, and we know that when we look at financial well-being and literacy in women, that this is not a New Zealand issue, it's not an Australian issue, this is a global initiative. How does New Zealand place in terms of financial well-being and literacy for women compared to other countries and globally?
Cracking that question. Look, I think that there's some standard challenges that face women. One being around, confidence, financial confidence. And it's not because we don't know this stuff, because we do. And when we do it, we do it extremely well. But there is an aspect around the confidence. And if I just look at myself, for example, I could improve sort of substantially. But I think one of the things that I read recently around this sort of transfer of wealth is that when women get money, they're great. In fact, we're just not getting enough of it. So I think that's really going to sort of change the conversation.
We're talking a lot about financial literacy and well-being for women. And, and you talked about we're talking about it, but we're not seeing it in action. what would be the one or two things that New Zealand could do right now that would have a significant shift for women?
Well, I think we need to bring women to the table in the speaker product design. I think we need to sort of get the right lens across our products so that we do have equality of sort of split. I think we do need to increase contributions to KiwiSaver and obviously as Jane Wrightson has called out in your research and you know how we do that. We just need to get around the table to discuss the options. I mean, you know, this thing to call out, well, come on employers, let's increase those contributions. That's not necessarily an easy fix, but we just need to come together to sort of actually have the conversation and to challenge the sort of the norms and preconceived ideas and get some sort of out-of-the-box thinking. So it is a team effort. It's not just a conversation that, you know, the private board table, etc. It's something that we all need to, you know, be involved in. And I think that's, you know, that's part of what we're doing within EPSC, the sort of the coming together, like-minded people to drive this change. We don't need to be working in individual silos. We need to, you know, come together.
You mentioned in the beginning, part of your journey was Women in Super. And recently, FSC had an amazing event on March 27th, where we launched Empower Women. And that was the Women in Super merging with the FSC. What a spectacular event. If you could bottle the energy in the room and sell that, we would both be women millionaires. We would join that club. Tell me about Empower Women. Tell me what it is and why it's so important.
Okay, so as you can see, it is a result of the merger of Women in Super into EPSC, which is great. It's about the establishment of a new community of like-minded people, not just women, people. Anyone is able to join. It's very inclusive. And we're really sort of focusing on impactful change and actions in respect to supporting women in relation to financial confidence, well-being and empowerment. So there's a lot of great stuff there. And, you know, what I like is that it's all about sort of breaking down these silos. I think, you know, it's not that we don't do some great stuff within the industry and external to the industry, but it's all these pockets. And that's what we found during the It Starts With Action campaign, where we were coming across these wonderful organisations and individuals doing great stuff around financial well-being in the community that we just didn't know about. So why can we not identify them, come together and support them to help them grow, because they're the ones with the connection with the people that we want to sort of get to. So Empower Women is really around, you know, I think it's, I like to think of it as, yeah, it's breaking the membership and all. You know, it is inclusive. Anyone can join. You don't have to be an FSC member. You don't have to be within the financial services world to join. It's anyone with that's interested in a sort of space and wants to come together to collaborate, to make change for women. So I think that that's pretty exciting. There is no fee to join. So again, coming back to, we're breaking down the silos and the barriers to, well, there can be hindering sort of the action. So I think it's really exciting in that sort of space. And we've got a lot of great sort of initiatives. So we need that, we need to grow the community and to get that powerful voice behind us to drive this change.
I'm really excited about what Empower Women can bring, not only to the FSC, but to the industry. For more information, go on to the FSC website for information on Empower Women. Please join. Please, we had an amazing response, over 150 members so far, and that's just in a week's time. So this promises to be a huge initiative and to bring the necessary change. Obviously, we've talked about a huge response we've had with people joining Empower Women. But Empower Women means that everyone can join. But do we have men?
Well, we really want men in the room. I think it's just so important to the success of this initiative. I mean, we put out the invite. Please do take us all up and join us. I mean, our male allies are really, really important. And I think, you know, what we need to sort of appreciate is the challenges that face women impact men, impact their daughters, their wives and sisters, their businesses. And, you know, picking up your earlier point to the, you know, in relation to the power of the female so consumer segment, it's important to our community. So, you know, why would you not come and join us?
So welcome, Tracey. It was great to chat to you and looking forward to some of the initiatives that you have coming forward.
Thank you.